tell me big up Jamaica, the land of food and water. The system might not prop up, look at vibes of food and the culture. Whoa, can't you see the beauty of this crew? But where is that bus that you just disposed of? We are singing about the beauty of this country, and yet still you're subtracting from the beauty of this country.
But it's just a song.
Listen, my brother, we are talking about the beauty of Jamaica. Did you know that tourism accounts for 10% in our GDP? 25% of our workforce is employed in the tourism industry. You might be wondering, how does tourism link to the disposal of one plastic bottle improperly? Here is how it's linked. Now, that plastic bottle disposed of improperly will run down into the drains, into our system, rivers, run right into our beaches. Most of the tourists visit Jamaica because of our beautiful beaches. And if our beaches are not beautiful, then tourists won't want to visit Jamaica. If tourists don't visit Jamaica, our GDP will fall and also unemployment rates will increase.
Okay, Jamaica has approximately 3 million citizens living in the country. And if I, as an individual, go and pick up that bottle right there and dispose of it properly, what about the rest of the country? How will they impact from what I have done?
No, my friend. This is how it works. You see, recycling is like magic.
Presenting.
Miniature Space Savers. My name is Shanice Hall and this is... And we are from Herbert Morrison Technical High School. The name of our company is KTI and our product is Miniature Space Savers. Now, basically, Miniature Space Savers is a recycled bottle with added value that is used to contain your essential items such as stationery.
Miniature Space Savers, well, this little item, as you see right here, we are aiming for the students, teachers, anyone in an office position who has stationery that they would want to, small stationery such as pens, pencils, even makeup designers, their highlighters, and all that necessary.
Yes, here is the trick. As business person, we need to study a person's mindset and work around their mindset. Here is it. Persons like to think that they are socially responsible, but really and truly, are you socially responsible? Now I know you won't go around and take off a bottle off the street and add value to it or anything like that, but here's the concept. You purchase just a Miniature Space Saver from us. We'll go out there, we'll take up the bottle from you, add value, and in turn it will contribute to you saving space.
Well, Miniature Space Holders, this costs $550 and the price to make it is about $300.
Yes.
And we have sold about 50, almost 50 of them. And it's we are high demanding for our teachers and all office positions at schools and the school.
Exactly. Why the price of this is so high is because we haven't experienced economies of scale as yet. So do not be frightened by the price, which will be gradually lower. No, our mission is never static, always dynamic. We want to enhance social responsibility. We want to ensure that our beaches, our rivers are clean of all plastics and buses. We started out our company with $12,000. And our sales so far, as we said, are 50 sold. And the process is very simple. We just add value to our plastic, clean it out, of course, and add value to this plastic. Now, did you know, Terry, that the government enhances this program, Nodotsi of Jamaica? Do you know the lyrics?
Yes, I do.
Nodotsi of Jamaica, please don't do it. No dash, no paper, no dash, no plastic. Dispose of God, which is God's split. No, no, recycle, clear the chicken, but things like it. Alright. And be a part of the solution, not the pollution. Thank you.
Okay. focus on recycling bottles and turning them into a product.
Okay, no, we haven't realized that in Montego Bay there's a serious problem with buses. If you read, I'm not sure if you're from Montego Bay. Okay, we have the Montego Bay River that flows right into the beach, right? So here we call it Dumpo. It's Dumpo for a reason because it's Dumpo with plastic buses. No, we realize the mindset of an individual person that they think that they are socially responsible. But most times, persons won't go here and take up a plastic bottle off the street or wherever it is stored. No, we'll go out here, we'll take it up for you, we'll pay, we'll add value. And not only say you buy something as a souvenir, it can also be used as a tool to store whatever item you like.
I commend you on recognizing, you know, a terrible problem, which is the pollution. But I think what you have to look at is what's the business proposition that you're offering in return, right? People spend money based on what they get out of something.
Yes.
It's a very straight relationship. And I sense that you're preying on people's wanting them to do the right thing. But you have to ask yourself, are you making them feel bad enough to do the right thing? Because I don't know that your business model, you know, I don't know how, you sell at $800? Is the retail price on that?
$500.
It's $550, and what was the other $300 you said?
$500.
Oh, so you're making $250 per unit. The question you have to ask yourself is, for a pencil case or a vestibule, is $550 relative to the other competing products really going to make you buy it?
Okay.
Because nobody's going to buy it just based on it's going to make the rivers. Because if they felt that, think about it this way, they wouldn't throw it out the window.
All right. Here's my solution for your question. No, you would say, we said earlier in our presentation that we haven't experienced economies of scale as yet. Now, when we experience economies of scale, the price for this miniature space here will decrease. If you look at this item, we'd say a pencil holder or whatever.